I realised there were people who actually, never mind, couldn't remember it, went for, Councillor Barrington, Councillor Hall, Councillor Lavelle, Councillor Tilly. So how do you explain what actually was happening in our country at that time? First, believe it or not, you're going to be shocked, I was there. I was very young. I've got a photograph here to show you. Show me the Guardian on the 30th anniversary. I'll show you the photo. It shows me running away, I hasten to add. Although Councillor Oakes disputes that, not because he thought I was brave, but he's never seen me run in his life. Because it was called the Battle of Orgreave. No, it wasn't a battle, it was an assault on people lawfully protesting. The first battle was actually just getting there. Because as a young activist, we made a number of journeys there, and he had to avoid the police roadblocks on many different wet routes. Because the police would stop you, illegally hold you, and send you back after the protest had taken place. And I'd be interested, Councillor Kemp and Councillor Radford would have both been proud members of the Liberal Party there, what their view around justice is around that, and fairness, and the ability to protest peacefully. This took place 7 miles from Hillsborough. And being the Hillsborough survivor, I know something about truth and justice and about how the South Yorkshire Police actually act. This matter needs to be addressed. For 27 years, the Hillsborough survivors, supported by ourselves and supported by the Yorkshire Islanders, fought for truth and justice. All I want is for us to add our pressure, our concerns, our voice. And I'll take the very last paragraph here. It says, Liverpool City Council therefore calls on both the Prime Minister and Home Secretary to order a full public inquiry into the deployment and actions of the South Yorkshire Police on the 18th of June 1984, and to conduct meaningful discussions with the Orgreave Truth and Justice Campaign, the NUM, I'm concerned that it's, and I genuinely hope that every member in this chamber can support this motion.
Only too often in this city, what we both knew then was that ours and ours was theirs. A shared sense that those with responsibility had escaped and the finger had been pointed back at the victims. Yes, at the victims. Orgreave was a coking plant. That is, it was a place that turned coal into a fuel that was particularly useful in the steel industry. An industry that not only supported the city of Sheffield, but gave it the nickname it holds. Orgreave was central to the working class life of Steel City. Because of that, at the end of the row of buildings in Haymarket in the city centre, built into the wall through an ingenious use of bricks, is a portrait of a steel worker. Marvellous working class art. It overlooks Snig Hill Police Station, which for many years used to be the headquarters of South Yorkshire Police. As I walk past on my way home from work and past the odd jar, I like to think that this hand-built mural to the working history of a fine city looked down as a constant reminder to its neighbours who sought to denigrate and deprive of justice from innocent people. A common struggle, familiar foes, we should support them as they have supported us. Justice for the 96 we have often cried. Let's also join with the cries for justice for Orgreave.
Should demand that this fire be public, be made responsible for both injustices. On behalf of the Orgreave Truth and Justice campaign, I would like to ask this council to support their plea and echo the calls that were made upon the new Home Secretary today to move with an inquiry where the documents are revealed in an unredacted form. The response from Amador today stated that she doesn't want to rush anything and she'd like to familiarise herself with the context. Well, as Peter said, it's only been 32 years, so suppose she would like us to thank her for the acknowledgement and sit back and wait for her to be familiar. But my Lord Mayor, I don't think that we can. I think that we should demand in the strongest possible terms that she begin this inquiry at the earliest time. Because I believe that this is not just in the interest of the miners and their families. I believe it is in the interest of this city and the justice that we will never tire of seeking for our very own 96.
We often monthly member, those fantastic miners' wives and daughters who for 12 months sustained them, if anything, told them to get out there on medication, I'm sure, and we've probably thanked them a great deal, and I hope from them we know a lot of good people have come forward. So the next time someone tells us that Liverpool shouldn't be debating this kind of topic because it was in South Yorkshire, I just remind you, as I do now, that Sutton Manor and our people aren't in Orgreave, and we should remember that. Thank you, Mother. Thank you.
Thank you. suggest, since this is such an important debate, that we do move whatever standing order is required to make sure that more people can speak than we'd normally be allowed to respect the
Well, maybe I'm
Saturday, isn't it disgusting that the euro is almost on
The same newspaper that the week before said, get out of Europe, without realising what the consequences are. And the consequences are huge, and the uncertainty is huge. But we've got to move on. And moving on through the International Festival for Business in 2016 and 2018, the Liverpool Commonwealth Association, and what we can do with our Commonwealth partners and trading outside of Europe. And let's actually take this opportunity to do more exporting with those countries that are part of the Commonwealth and part of Brazil and India and China, etc. I did miss one out a little bit. 2 weeks ago, the Deputy Mayor and I attended an event to launch the Merseyside Enterprise Hub, where Europe gave us money for the Merseyside Liverpool City region to go out and support businesses. We are still getting money from Europe to continue doing business. And that's great to see. But the government needs to be sending out a message that it is business as usual at the moment and stop the uncertainty. And it's wonderful to see that the Liverpool City region is calling for to be at the negotiation table with the government to ensure that we don't lose out any more based on the lack of communication and the lack of a plan B from our national government. Ladies and gentlemen, please support this motion. It is business as normal, we hope. Let's do more exporting and let's do more trade. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. Now I've got 10 people speaking total and I've got 5 people who are actually seconding the motion. So I'm going to allow all seconders 3 minutes to speak. Everybody over and above that will have 2 minutes to speak. So you don't want this to go on all night. Okay, so Councillor Rivers.
Thank you, Lord Mayor, and I really will be brief. Lord Mayor, we're all aware of how important the EU has been to Liverpool for many years and the terrible outcome of the referendum has been for the city. The results of the EU referendum came as a major blow to us as a city, and I can think of its evidence and the reaction since. From the vigil in St George's Hall to the record number of signatures on national petitions, the results have shocked the people of this city and this country. We're saying that all of this is a poor result for the Liverpool City region and the country overall. The results are shook us to the core, as I say. We might be tempted to focus on the dramatic and sometimes depressingly hilarious political changes in government, but this result will affect us in many different parts of our society in different ways, and really encourage everyone to visit the Forsyth Society's sites to look at the hashtag facehatefuture.org sites. It's really important to see just how hard won the rights of gender equality are, what we fought for so long, and how they are seriously under threat from Brexit. There's also been some very concerning and tangible results from Brexit. Some things, although we can't necessarily hold them in your hands, they may affect our salaries, but more importantly, nonetheless, we need to make sure that we move forward with this and ensure that mendacity does not win the day. The blatant and barefaced falsehoods of the Leave campaign has cheapened politics, the political debate in this country, way past anything we've seen before. Weeks of shameful demagoguery have given rise to mindless, inexcusable acts of racism that are appearing on our streets, in our shops, doctors, stadiums, and places of work. So let us make one thing completely clear right now. This city does not and will not tolerate racism or hate of any kind. People from across the world living here in Liverpool, contributing to our communities and society, who are as much part of Liverpool as anybody else in this chamber. We are a city proud of our diversity and our culture, and we will always stand for and support the rights of those who make our community great. There is no doubt that things are going to get worse and we face a future of uncertainty. There is going to be real significant effects on all of us, with knock-on effects that we don't even know yet. But while we are elected here for the people of this city to stand up to that uncertainty and to act quickly and responsibly, if Liverpool knows anything, it's how to stand strongly in the face of adversity. Once again, we face a challenge, but it is a challenge we can overcome together. This administration is committed to being the strong voice for this city. The road ahead is not going to be easy, but it's one that we have no choice but to travel down. So we owe it to everyone in this city to make sure that we reach the destination in one piece. We are always better together. Thank you.
distorted picture of what big macro immigration really is. The Leave campaign made it into a scapegoat of everything what is wrong with this country, conveniently silencing the fact that the reason why so many people are getting poorer and poorer is not immigration, but the failed austerity policy of the Conservative government. It is imperative that we change the narrative here and ensure that all people in Liverpool are presented with the true and accurate picture of immigration. In order to succeed in this, I propose that a cross-party multi-stakeholder group is set up, which will meet regularly with the representatives of migrant communities and relevant agencies in order to communicate and consult with each other and bring together various groups and communities. There are currently so many migrant community groups individually trying to tackle similar issues. Such groups, when working together with the support of the council, are so much more likely to be successful in improving community cohesion. I have met with representatives of various communities who have some excellent ideas how to strengthen neighbourly links, ranging from a positive media campaign about benefits of migration to organising concerts and events with artists from various countries. Community groups are already organising many events like that individually. The joint approach and effort would result in something done on a much greater scale, with much further reaching outcomes. Schools Parliament has also got some fantastic ideas and can refer to good practice already happening in the local schools, such as inviting speakers to assemblies to discuss immigration, diversity week showing positive aspects of migration through dance, cookery or art, or the value of the work of the Youth Council on the Don't Hate, Educate campaign. There are so many great community leaders in Liverpool working towards the strengthening of community cohesion. As a result of the referendum and the uncertainty that followed, they and the organisations they run have now even more drive and will to work together. I welcome the fact that the Mayor has held a meeting with them, but let's take it further. Let's harness this positive energy and set up a permanent group that will work together to reach out with a positive message about integration to all people in Liverpool, especially those who normally not engage, in order to strengthen the links between so many diverse communities in our great city.
Thank you very much. And I also say as well that I'm not allowing any extensions because we've got so many speeches for this debate. I'm not allowing any extensions. Okay. I'm sorry about that. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Councillor Kemp.
My lover, thank you for calling me. This is an important debate. It's important that we don't dwell on the Leave campaign, but we do understand why people voted Leave. My colleagues and I knocked on thousands of doors during the referendum campaign, and there were two reasons that people voted Leave. The first was they believed there was a cornucopia of riches that could be spent on the National Health Service and everything else. But that wasn't true. The Leave campaign remorselessly used that figure, although they were told time and time again by the National Statistics Authority that that figure was bogus. And although it was bogus, it didn't stop them spending the money on everything that they thought would win the vote. It's also important to realise that when most of the arguments that Leave put forward were lost, they resorted quite blatantly, quite openly, to a campaign on immigration which was largely a racist and offensive campaign. And we are reaping the problems of that now, with a 57% increase in hate crimes since the referendum. So what are we going to do about it? Well, in the short time that I've got, I just want to deal with one particular item, which I've already alluded to in my exchange with the Mayor before. I believe we've now got to make the Liverpool City region work at a much higher level than we had originally even dreamed of. We have to work on the assumption that this group of 1.75 million people, which is actually bigger than a quarter of the countries in the world, will actually function as a city-state, going out to challenge within Europe, within London, within the rest of the world for jobs, prosperity, scientific research, and all those things which are threatened. But I would just say there are two things we need to do. We need to improve the governance of what is proposed so that it becomes an assembly with a mayor like the London model, which is well known, clearly understood, and clearly a focus of attention. And we need to change the proposed management structure, which will simply create a tedious second-class county council. We need to attract into this machinery, if we are going to be a city, region, state, people such as permanent secretaries from BID, permanent secretaries from the Department of Education, permanent secretaries from the Foreign Office, who can actually walk the corridors of power all over the world with us on our behalf. And I have pledged to the Mayor on behalf of my Liberal Democrat colleagues throughout the city region that we will work with him to that end.
Thank you very much, Councillor Kemp. Okay, Councillor Radford.
My Lord Mayor, I was grateful that all parties agreed to compensate the council motion in a very constructive way, but we still had to disagree. But then sadly, the speeches tonight have done exactly the opposite. Men in suits, well, it was the same men in suits in Westminster from your party. Which party is it this week? Lib Dem or Labour? Your parties, plural, were the ones who didn't want people to have a vote. And I think it's an arrogance, an offensive arrogance about you telling people how they shouldn't have voted in the referendum you didn't want to have.
No, they put it straight down the line.
And I think it's also an offensive, dishonest arrogance, suggesting that somehow the 17 million people in the United Kingdom who vote to liberate themselves in the European Union while somehow inherently racist. And that's the narrative that's coming home tonight. And I think that's deeply offensive, and it's deeply offensive to the very people who wouldn't have allowed people to have a vote. After they lied in several general elections promising a referendum on a constitution that then they didn't vote for. So I think, you know, let's put it straight in my mind. And Gary Miller did actually say people didn't watch very well. Well, the argument over Brexit, for many of us did argue, in the world, Britain go global, was in fact the EU is very slow moving in making international agreements, and Britain would be more flexible to improve world trade in the very economies outside of the nation. So it was quite dishonest to me, and let's make this quote about it, dishonest to suggest that there was any way from those people who voted to leave wanted less global trade. They were saying, let's get into the world where the trade can grow. That aside, the Liberal group is quite happy to contribute constructively to suggest that those people who have joined this country, contributed to this country, should have their respects recognised and protected. But in the same way, we should ask European governments to do the same. And that's the dishonesty about our opposition. Let's face it, wasn't it Mr. John who said, if we leave the EU as the world, end of world civilization, although it was World War III, let's put it right down the line. The United Kingdom, despite Brexit, voted contributing more task force protecting these European borders than any other country in the EU. Fact. And, you know, going to be quite honest about it, we do pay far more from the money we get into the EU. We have, in the United Kingdom, lost large numbers of international companies who've left having their tax base in the United Kingdom to go to Mr. Juncker's Duchy of Luxembourg, because they get 5% corporation tax. So we are disadvantaged by some benefits of the EU, but we're not, and I'm pleased, I would have supported the motion if we're thanking Mr. Juncker. We are thanking the European Commission quite rightly the contributions we have. The Cornish communities who equally voted to leave did actually ask for the National League campaigns to give some assurances for continuing to fund the national European type projects. We should do the same, and the Mayor taking that issue up at the joint task force. But I really do hope that this smear campaign about those people being all racist has been offensive to 17 million people in this country who voted to liberate themselves from the
EU. You did actually second this motion, didn't you?
Yes.
All right. Which bit did you want?
I will answer your question, my dear. We introduced the line for the immigration.
protection for people who are working here already and ask for a reciprocal arrangement for you for those who are in the United Kingdom working abroad.
Well, we did ask.
Amused. Right, Councillor Wallace. Is this your maiden speech? I know this is your second time on the council. Did you cancel the maiden speech?
But we'll be nice then.
We will. Thank you.
Thank you, my Lord Mayor. I'm going to be a brief regarding this. We remember the party of the party that campaigned straight after to remain in Europe after local elections. We did not stop. We held small street markets, small markets, encouraging people to use their own. So we campaigned hard on this, and it was a big surprise to us when the nation decided to leave, but obviously we were quite relieved that Liverpool decided to remain. I'm very concerned of what the impact it will have on our city in terms of funding street, as Liverpool has benefited so much from the European Social Fund. If we didn't have that money, if that money hadn't come to the city would be a totally different place to what it is now. So there's a lot that I'm grateful for the European Social Fund. And also, it's also right that the City Council should condemn hate crime. I was really pleased that the city leaders, the city ethnic minority leaders and immigrant leaders of the Salvation Immigration Communities all gathered together at St. George's Hall early this month to stand together to condemn any prejudice or hatred, verbal abuse or attacks on any immigration community. I myself have benefited from immigration and immigrated to this country as a child. I was educated here. I've done well in the city, I've prospered, I've had promoted opportunities. As so, there's other immigration groups in the city